Data integrity is a key feature of IDEA. Once data is imported, it cannot be edited. Instead, we can add new fields to test and validate data. In the previous exercise, we joined the payments and authorization databases. And now we want to see if there are any payments that exceed the limit for the authorizer. However, we just found out that the company recently increased authorization limits by 20%, and this was not reflected in the authorization database. Let's add a new field to calculate the new authorization limits, and then we can compare the new limit to the payment amount. First, make sure the payments with authorization database is active. There are several ways to add a new field to a database. On the Data tab, in the Fields group, we can click Add, but many people prefer the right-click method, so I will show that. Click any cell within the Limit field. Then, right-click the Limit field header and select Add Field. In the field name, enter new_limit. Field names cannot contain spaces. But if you enter spaces, they will be converted to underscores automatically. For field type, we will select virtual numeric. Any of the virtual field types, virtual numeric, virtual character, etc., are determined by an equation, and it's that equation, not the resulting values, that is stored in the database. This means the equation can be modified and recalculated. Length is not required for a numeric field. Enter two decimal places. The parameter is the equation that will be used to calculate the new field. Here, we will enter the equation limit times 1.2. We can type this equation directly, or we can click on the equation editor button to help us write more complex equations. In the description field, type updated authorization limit, then click OK. The new field was added to the right of the field that was selected right before I right-clicked to add the field. It is a different color to distinguish it from the originally imported data. Now, let's compare the new authorization limit with the payments to see if there are any payments that exceed the limit. On the Analysis tab, in the Extract group, click Direct. In the file name, enter Exceeded Authorization Limits. Click the Equation Editor button and enter an equation to compare the two fields. Let's enter Amount is greater than New Limit and click the Validate and Exit button. Click OK to run the direct extraction. The output contains three records, the three records with a blank value for the auth field, meaning that all of the payments with a valid authorizer were within their authorization limit. When you are done reviewing the output, right-click any of the database tabs and click Close All Tabs.